5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Are you sitting comfortably?
What do you want me to say?
Then we'll begin.
I hope you enjoy it. I think you will.
So, Steve, what fond memories do you have of these people? Are they your friends?
The force of gravity makes you want to move. In parts of your body, it's...
Stop playing with that radio, yours. I'm trying to get to sleep.
Thank you, Julian. Indeed, Opus Air Live is life. But as any radio presenter will tell you that the live, of course, is evil spelt backwards. If you're live, something else goes wrong. The art, of course, is to let no one know it's going wrong. All good to see you on the good ship Phluid. Apart from, say, the chat room, it seems to be working. You can get into it. I can't see what you're talking about. So I will just say, I assume that Alan Plum's in. I assume that Hugh James is in. Dr. Kerno is a given. Sandy possibly, bass driver more than likely. Missing from the parade last week was Electric Monk. Roger wasn't there. Ue Roger. Hopefully he's back this week. I can't tell if you're in the chat room or not, unfortunately. Chat amongst yourselves, if that works, I don't know. Well, it's a mixed bag this soon. Got the birthdays coming up very, very shortly. We have got, of course, the cover this evening. We're going mellow. We're going to go a little bit like that, a bit mellow, a bit of chilled. I can't do that. No, mellow music this evening. That's what we have. A bit of Falco. The late, great Falco will be on a bit later on. Well, obviously on, because he's dead, but you know what I mean. We have got new music from Boy with Uke and Claire Rosenkranz. Bit of Kate Bush, bit of Grace Jones, and a bit more malarkey in the meantime. If you're coming down to Liscard in the next upcoming month, so in December, we are running the gigs down at JJ's. Some cracking bands are going to be showing. We've got Payday Friday. It's not a band, it's an evening. Get your money in, get your guys down to the pub, spend some money, listen to some gigs, let's have some birthdays. He is 74, he is called Joe Regan. Egan. Need some Steeler's Wheel. Well, there goes Mr. Joe Egan there from Steeler's Wheel, singer, songwriter, stuck in the middle with you. Another birthday today. He's 58. His name rhymes with tigers. It is, of course, Scottish Tigers. Doit. Doit, look at Tiger. He rhymes with tigers. Scottish Tigers. He is blowing out 58 candles in his cake today. Called a fire brigade for that one. We have got two more birthdays coming up just after this. So what do we know? What do we know? Well, bed bugs. Bed bugs, bed bugs. They're coming to get us, it would seem. Sneaky bed bugs, it says here, are lurking in our wardrobes during the day before launching their nighttime attacks under the duvet. It says here, by the time we wake up, the psycho pests have headed back to the dark crevices around the bedroom. I've got to tell you, I do not want any bed bugs in my dark crevices. Thank you very much. Professor Mary Cameron of London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine issued a warning as the UK sees a surge in the critters. You don't want surging bed bugs, do you? It says here, warm weather means they hatch in just 2 days with a doubling of the population every couple of weeks. Well, there you go. Professor Cameron went on to say, though called bed bugs, they come into the bed to bite you when it's dark, but scurry into cracks and crevices of wardrobes. Keep away from cracks and crevices. She said, they're resistant to most insecticides, so a pest controller, Roland, would probably be needed to deal with an infestation. What else do we know? It says women here. I don't know why it says women, but it says here women will have walked more than 40,000 miles. By the time they are 50, including down the aisle, to and from work, and exploring new countries. Don't forget to and from the sink, to and from the kitchen, to and from the shops. With a sexism. A study of women also found they typically take 51,000 steps, or approximately 24,000 miles over the average week. It also meant that in their career, they're on their feet for 7 hours a day. Let's have some more birthdays. 49 today, Peter Svensson. He's a songwriter for the Cardigans, you know, other jumpers are available. It's all about raisins, this one, Raisins and Rewinds. From the album Gran Turismo, other driving games are available. God, you remember Pole Position from the 80s on the ZX80 on the Spectra? Amazing graphics, not. There you go, the Cardigans there. Celebrating the birthday. 49 today, Peter Svensson. Just a quick reminder that, of course, the chat room is open this evening, but I cannot see what you're putting on there. Hopefully there's nice comments. Hopefully there's somebody on there. Who knows? It's time for the final birthday of Simon. He is 46. His name is Simon Ricks. And he is a basics. It's bassist. Kaiser Cheese, what did you do today? What did you learn at school? Nothing to both those answers and questions. It's Ricky. The guys, Chiefs there, never miss a beat, of course, celebrating the birthday of Simon Ricks, the bassist, who's 46. Let's have one of these pointless surveys, shall we? It says here, ditching flat pack furniture, being happy to spend money on carpets, and booking more holidays among signs someone's middle-aged, according to the study. Those closer to reaching midlife will appear happier, spending time scouring garden and home stores for fun. And more likely to care about matching cushions and want to invest in quality cutlery and crockery. Half the say being middle-aged means it is more likely you know what you want out of life. Researchers also discovered that now middle age is 47. Many believe reaching middle age means you take a vested interest in looking good. Yeah, right, joining a gym, to spending money on good food, understanding which wines are featured on the top 50 list. This one is a homebrew. Plucker's Plums this evening. So, it says, they're quite chewy. There's 50 signs that you're middle-aged. The top one is you start to notice that people at work aren't your age and could potentially be your children. Well, old enough to be, not potentially could be your children, unless you've been spreading your wild seed somewhere. I don't get this so much on... No, it's that you start living your life on Facebook, documenting every event. I think kids do that. I don't middle-aged do that. You start drinking smoothies and cutting out bread, pizza and cakes. No. Ah, here's a good one. You won't eat with a knife and fork set that don't match. I'm a bit like that. You suddenly change your hair colour. Yeah, right, mine's grey. You decide to go back to school or train in something that's new to prove you're not told to learn. We'll do a few more of those after this next track, and the cause is madness. Shut up! Wasn't me, mate. Didn't see you do it. Can't prove it. It is madness. It is pure madness. Of course, we all know the first signs of madness is Suggs walking up the driveway. No fear, have no fear. The covers, they are here with Jingle This Week. Cover me. And we've gone all mellow this evening. This is Bird. The Paul Weller classic, You Do Something To Me. Wow, covering the Paul Weller classic there. That was Bridie, Bride, Bird. I don't know, it's B-R-Y-D. You, I don't know, you decide. This next is Daisy Clark. Cover the Coldplay classic. Scientist. Daisy Cooper there. Finish on the covers this evening, of course, of the classic Coldplay song called Scientist. Let's get back to this survey show. This wonderful survey is all about... Where's my bed? Here we are. It's a cute little pigeon. 50 signs you're middle-aged. Put your hand up if you recognise any of these. You know exactly what takeaways stroke dinner you like and you order the same every time. Why wouldn't you? It's just no-brainers, really. You suddenly start shopping in the butchers and the greengrocers. You eschew the superstores and supermarkets. You know what? I don't have one. Your fridge is packed with healthy vegetables. No, I don't think so. When you leave the house, you are super prepared for every eventuality. I'm always caught out. I hate being hot. I really hate being too hot. So I don't think I actually own a jumper. I seriously own a jumper. Might be a sweatshirt, possibly. Rugby top, but I don't really do jumpers. Cardies. But no, I sort of go out, sort of short sleeve shirts. And think, really cold then. I hate getting too hot. You love scouring the home stores and garden stores. You try to get on with your kids' friends and be cool in front of them. There's nothing worse than the cool parent, the uber cool parent. What else have we got? You invest, that's not me of course, you invest in a new motor sports car or impressive motorhome. As if I'd invest in a flashy sports car in my middle age. You're conflicted about whether to try and dress to match modern trends, give up on that one, or what it just feels comfortable. That's an elasticated waist for me, thank you. You suddenly start hosting loads of dinner parties. What's cheaper than going out, isn't it? If you stay in, it's cheaper than going out. And you can drink, you can go about getting a taxi, drink driving, us malarkey, you've got to worry about paying for the drinks because they're yours. Cheers. What else we got? You start planning major renovations to your home. Because you've got more money when you're this age, of course. You join a gym to fight middle-aged, but I did that start this year. I've not been for absolutely ages. I don't think this is me either. You know exactly what I'd listen to on the radio. I won't tolerate new bands. I like new bands. I mean, a lot of them do sound the same, admittedly. And you'd rather spend your money on home decor than anything else. Well, yes, there's some of the 50 signs that you're getting middle-aged. Or in fact, you are middle-aged. I won't tell anybody. My lips are sealed. Just like Fun Boy 3 from the album Waiting. Happy Hancock. With his scratchy old rocket. That sounds a bit rude. That's in bedbugs. Yeah, it's got to be time for another wonderful and pointless surveys. It says here, folks, we will spend a whopping 8 years of our lives. 8 years of our lives. Modern Rants. No, I'm doing household chores. Study was found today. The average adult. Is there such a thing as an average adult? I've got to say, I went to Plymouth at the weekend. There's no one average in Plymouth. My God, what a bunch of weirdos there are there. Anyway, it says if you can find them, the average, and you can, that's only 18. The average adult spends just under 3 hours a day doing tasks around the home, like cleaning, food shopping, and walking the dog. This amounts to nearly 21 hours a week, the equivalent of 45 days a year, or 7 years and 10 months during the average lifetime. And a crazy quarter of us even say we enjoy doing housework. Research went on to find that the cooking takes up most time, accounting for 4 hours and 30 minutes each week. Washing up and cleaning up the kitchen takes an hour and 38 minutes a week. Eminem cleans out his closet, that takes a bit longer. An hour is spent cleaning the bathroom. And another hour a week is spent doing the dreaded ironing, while vacuuming takes up another hour. Defrosting that freezer, ironing and removing hair from plug holes. Also fish on the list with unblocking the sink and cleaning the skirting boards. Make it, who cleans their skirting boards? I suppose it depends how dirty your house really does in the first place. Other chores in the most hated list include cleaning out the fridge, that's the wife's job, cleaning the barbecue, cleaning my job, mowing the lawn, cleaning my job, and washing that colour. It's all men's jobs, this! Lucky 1 in 20 even said they employ a cleaner doing most of the chores. But I've got to tell you, folks, if you employ a cleaner, what we got to do is do a pre-clean before I turn up. Heaven forbid the clean since we're dirty. Well, what do you need a cleaner for in the first place? Most disliked jobs in the home, disliked chores. Number one is cleaning the oven. Number two is cleaning the windows. Oh, God, I really hate smeary windows. Smeary window, that's Tina Turner. Can't abide them, I can't clean them either. I only get a window cleaner. Clean the mould from his shower, grouting. Let's have one more truck, it's Falco! He's got a phone call coming on, folks. Hello? Vienna? This guard calling.
Hello?
Hello? Wonderful Mr. Late, the great Falco. He, of course, a Rock Me Amadeus Flame. You played that, didn't we, with the covers last week? Leo, the metal guy. They're not scrap, mate. He does metal songs, covers. Wow, from one dead legend to another. Oh, what a link. I don't want to go out, I want to stay in. That's the wrong song, isn't it? Anyways, David Bowie.
I know when to go out.
I'll stay in.
I know when to stay in.
Where's Les Dance?
Get things done.
I can't support the boy. David Bowie, now it's time for this. At 8:04, a political party that vows to give people free beer is surging in the polls. Funny that, the beer party is in third place on a whopping 12%. That's quite strong, isn't it? And rising in state elections across Austria. Its policies include a beer fountain in Vienna and a 50% tax on Radlers, a low-alcohol beer made with juice. It also vows a buyback scheme for Radlers so the drink can be exchanged for real beer. Officials even propose to give all households in the region a free monthly barrel with 50 litres earmarked per adult. Lovely. Heating experts have now had their say on the exact date we're putting the heating on. Christmas Day in this house. They've used Met Office data for the last 5 years to advise on just how long it will be before we whack up the heating. The NHS advises put your heating on at least 18 degrees when temperatures outside drop below 15 degrees. And heating specialists say that, therefore, in line with Met Office data, we can expect to be turning the heating on the 20th of October, which is in 2 days' time, according to my maths. Many of us here, it says, have avoided a split with a partner because they've missed the other half's pet too much. Fifth of singletons, not simpletons, say they're stuck with a relationship that's not working due to an animal. A further 44% claim that the prospect of leaving a furry friend makes them more heartbroken than life without their partner. Meanwhile, 45% say they're stuck with someone because the prospect starting over makes them anxious. The world's most expensive tin of baked beans signed by Christa Burt go out for auction. This creates more questions than answers this question, but there you go. The survey, where's it gone to? We've lost it now. Yeah, the can was autographed by the Lady in Red singer and given to his head of merch on tour. Graham Budd Auctions will sell it in a vinyl pop culture auction on Wednesday in Western Supermare, Somerset. It's expected to fetch £80. Well, there you go. Finally, tea drinkers boil double the amount of water they need when making a brew. It says they're wasting 70 millions of water every year. Enough to fill 20 Olympic swimming pools. I love that. We just break things down to double-decker buses, Olympic swimming pools, and Wembley. Let's have some strolling bones. They miss you. From the album, Some Girls. Some will, some won't, some what? Who cares? Was it some will, some won't, some will, some won't? So what? That's Nev. Nev from the office. Not the office. What's it called? I can't remember what it's called now. Anyway, he's dead now. Ain't he, Nev? Poor Nev. Is it just me or is a shooting star sort of ruined that song? Haven't they? He's a baby. Oh dear. Let's have a few more surveys, shall we? It says here, taking your socks off at dinner parties, big no-no, we're talking sex is fine. I'll take the pants off, probably worse than a party, there you go. Looking at your phone, vaping at the table and chatting up politics are also among top 10 things guests should avoid, a study claims. So as we know, of course, all us mid-40s, all us 40-somethings are middle-aged people, having dinner parties left, right and centre, aren't we? Other habits frowned upon at the table include outstaying your welcome, boasting about how much you earn considerably better off than you, and posting a picture of the food's dinner, and posting a picture of the host's food to Instagram asking, poll is found. Other good things to do at dinner table include asking people of their lives rather than talk about yourself, seating men and women together rather than in gender groups, as well as asking about allergies and dairy requirements beforehand. If you're a vegan, bugger off. Weekends are becoming increasingly boring, as 7 in 10 of us say we stop going out. Almost 3/4 of us rarely leave the comfort of our sofa on a Friday or Saturday night, a poll that's aged between 80 and 65 has said. Nothing on telly though, is there? Good box set on the go. Oh, speaking of Netflix. I immediately forgot what the thing was called. A Hit and Run. Dare I say it's an Israeli-based drama. Crossover to New York. And it leaves the lead character on a real cliffhanger at the end. Spoiler alert, folks, there is no season 2. Why did they do this? Anyway, in 2019, almost half went out on the weekend to a restaurant, pub or a club. We are no longer a party nation, says, since COVID. We'd rather sit in front of the telly and go out. And finally, we are choosing destinations that look similar to swank resorts to cut costs. Why go to Benidorm when you can go to Rhyl in Wales? Instead of travelling to pricey hotspots such as Lake Como, we're going to the Lake District. People after sunny boond experiences are ditching South Africa for northern Spain. And it says Morocco has come a new Dubai. I'll tell you what is new. What a link, what a link, what a link. It is new music. We are kicking off first of all with Boy with Uke. Ukulele, of course, is problematic. It's from the album Lucid Dreams. Well, this is Boy with Uke. He's a 21-year-old South Korean singer, musician, internet personality who hides his appearance because he's pig ugly. Next come off the rank of Steve is Claire Rosenkrantz. She's a 19-year-old American singer, songwriter from California. She released her music first on social media. She's now signed to Republic Records, age 16. This is Swinging at the Stars from the album Just Because. Well, she's swinging at the stars. That is Claire Rosenkrantz. Finish off the new music for this evening. It is 25 minutes past the 8. Big thanks for tuning in. See, I can't see who's tuned in however because the chat room is for me broken. Let's do a wonderful survey. The top 30 things for a little goes a long way include chocolate, meeting the in-laws and hair gel. A poll revealed the things in life we don't need too much for it to reap the benefits. Caffeine, squash and being on receiving end of a smile. Also met the list, as do a brisk walk outdoors. Yeah, walking, little that. Don't want too much of that, do you really? Getting a birthday card and, to quote Roger, a little respect and a wreath of Franklin, of course. It also emerged that 72% think it's the little things in life that can bring the most joy. Well, they would say that, wouldn't they? The study also revealed the little things that do bring them joy include hanging out with friends, hanging out the washing, no, sorry, playing games and indulging in a delicious meal. Having a catch-up with someone on the phone, changing the bed sheets and having a sweet treat. Also featured among the small actions that can brighten the day. This is like small actions of whatever it's called. I can't think of one thing, think of it anymore. It's random acts of kindness, same thing as that really, isn't it? But 72% said it's the little things that bring them the most joy, with 40% claiming it reminds them what's really important in life. Whilst 28% believe it is a little change routine brings the most impact, no matter how big or small. More than a third, that's 35%, you know, also believe a little bit of joy helps them stay mindful and provide a boost, a capitalist boost to their mental health. Brits would also rather be on the receiving end of a small, thoughtful gesture than something big and grand. 23% wished they had had more joy in their lives compared to what they currently get. While 27% of us struggle to live in the moment. In a list of top 30 things for a little goes a long way. A free drink. Number 4. Flowers, number 7. A joke. Yeah, that's too many jokes. Just a one or two. Washing up liquid and butter, not in the same bowl, hopefully. A shot of espresso coffee. Chili. Now, I love chili. I can have loads of that. Lots of it. Lots of chili, please. Soap. A little bit of soap goes a long way. And if you're into spice, of course, apparently 30 is ginger spice. A little bit of her goes the right way. My dreaded thing is Kate Bush. Grace Jones, our slave, he said, gotta be eating something. Very bad still on air, of course. Got the munchies. Very appropriate, this. It says this wonderful survey. It does indeed say, on average, we feel perfectly healthy less than half of the year. Less than that in my case. So I found that on the average, we experience 12 days a month with no aches, pains, or discomfort, which add up to just 144 days a year. It's not a surprise then that people turn to time-honored methods to relieve their ailments. 51% admitted to currently being relieving in at least one old wives' tale. The survey examined the little ailments people face and the old wives' tales they believe. 42% of us currently think cracking their knuckles results in arthritis. It says that in reality, cracking your knuckles is not doing any damage. The sound from the cracking is your synovial fluid bubbles in your joints just popping, which can cause some swelling of the hands but does not lead to arthritis. 40% of us think not eating carrots will improve. Hang on. 40% of us don't think eating carrots. It's not true. An apple a day keeps a doctor away. Yes, if aimed correctly. That's not true, of course. So, some of these old wives' tales. 45% believe sleeping wet hair will give you a cold. Nope, it'll give you a wet pillow. 45% believe that spices cure sinuses. Well, I'd imagine if you shove a ghost ship up your conch, it'd probably cure most things. 39% think coffee will stunt growth. Really? A cigarette surely does that. speaking of preventing colds, 47% think orange juice will prevent a cold. I've never listened before. 40% think eating turkey makes you tired. You know what it is, don't you? When do we eat turkey? At Christmas. When do we eat it? After we've unwrapped all the presents and fed everybody and we force home in front of the telly. Doesn't make us tired. 47% think chicken noodle soup clears colds. 44% of us believe you should feed a fever and starve a cold. And finally, 41% of us believe chocolate be an aphrodisiac. Well, there you go. Let's have Peter Gabriel shocking the monkey. I can assure you no monkeys were hurt in recording this music. From the album, Peter Gabriel 4, Security. Shock the monkey. Well, there you go. The best thing to come from the Isle of Wight since the Blue Funnel Ferry. Marking the boys at level 42. One more track to go before we say bye-bye. It is Crazy, the Orange Factory remix from Seal. Arf, arf. He loves to bounce a ball on his nose, you know. Well, the wonderful Seal there, Crazy Orange Factory remix, of course, there. What do we know, what do we know, what do we know? Don't forget, tomorrow you can catch the Water Pain. Great new music, guest interviews, community features, tier of the week, the gig guide, the quick quiz. It is all there for your deputation tomorrow night between 7 and 9. Start season 5, don't you know? Then, of course, you can visit our merchandise store. Look fresh and crispy on the streets. A range of merch, caps, t-shirts, and hoodies. And most importantly, of course, of all, don't forget to feed that there head of algorithm. Like, share, follow, subscribe. If you're on Facebook, it is /Fluid Records. Twitch is /Fluid Vision. Mixcloud /FM Fluid FM. Instagram is @Fluid Records. YouTube, Fluid Vision. And if you're twattering, tweeting, X-ray is called these days, it is @FM Fluid. As ever, thanks for listening, and make sure you join me again same time next week for much, much more the same. Thanks again. Bye for now.